This chapter will acquaint you with the content of the ISM code, the rules of classification societies regarding PSM.
Let's start with some definitions. International Safety Management Code, ISM, means the International Management Code for the Safe Operation of Ships and for Pollution Prevention as adopted by the Assembly.
A company means the owner of the ship or any other organization or person, such as the manager or the bareboat charterer, who has assumed the responsibility for the operation of the ship from the ship owner and who, on assuming such a responsibility, has agreed to take over all the duties and responsibility imposed by the code. Administration means the government of the state whose flag the ship is registered under.
The objectives of International Safety Management Code, ISM, are to ensure safety at sea, prevention of human injury or loss of life,
the avoidance of damage to the environment and in particular to the marine environment and to property.
Safety management of the company should, inter alia, provide for safe practice in ship operation and safe working environment, establish safeguards against all identified risks, continuously improve safety management skills of personnel ashore and aboard ships, including preparing for emergencies related both to safety and environmental protection. The safety management system should ensure compliance with mandatory rules and regulations, that applicable codes, guidelines and standards recommended by the organization, administrations, classification societies and maritime industry organizations are taken into account. Mater's responsibility and authority. The company should clearly define and document the master's responsibility with regard to implementing the safety and environmental protection policy of the company.
This means that the master has the overall responsibility for implementation of the SMS system, including the PMS, as long as the PMS is considered a part of the company's SMS.
Motivating the crew in the observation of that policy. As long as the PMS is considered a part of the SMS system, the master has the overall responsibility for motivating the crew regarding the use and improvement of the PMS. Refer also to Classification Note number 10.1 regarding implementation survey. Issuing appropriate orders and instructions in a clear and simple manner. All types of orders and instructions that may be predefined, such as routine checklists, safety precautions, work permits, etc., could be included in the PMS system.
Verify that specified requirements are observed. Review the SMS PMS and report its deficiencies to the shore-based management. Implement relevant routines and checklists and report deficiencies in the PMS.
Resources and personnel. The company should ensure that each ship is manned with qualified, certified and medically fit seafarers in accordance with national and international requirements. SDCW 78/95.
The RAST Win operation and maintenance system includes a separate module for resource management covering certificates and general skills for each member of the crew. The company should establish procedures to ensure that new personnel and personnel that are transferred to new assignments related to safety and protection of the environment are given proper familiarization in their duties.
This computer-based training module is considered an important part of such training, familiarization. The company should ensure that all personnel involved in the company's SMS have an adequate understanding of relevant rules, regulations, codes and guidelines. This computer-based training module is considered an important part of such training, familiarization. Development of plans for shipboard operations. The company should establish procedures for the preparation of plans and instructions for key shipboard operations concerning the safety of the ship and the prevention of pollution. The various tasks involved should be defined and assigned to qualified personnel. By establishing relevant procedures, checklists with adequate coding, etc., in the PMS, the code's requirements may be met. Maintenance of the ship and equipment.
The company should establish procedures to ensure that the ship is maintained in conformity to the provisions in relevant rules and regulations, and with any additional requirements which may be established by the company.
In meeting these requirements, the company should ensure that inspections are held at appropriate intervals,
any non-conformity is reported, including possible cause, if known,
appropriate corrective action is taken, records of these activities are maintained.
The company should establish procedures in its SMS, safety management system, to identify equipment and technical systems in which a sudden operation failure may result in a dangerous situation. The SMS should provide for specific measures aimed at promoting the reliability of such equipment or systems. These measures should include the regular testing of standby arrangements and equipment or technical systems that are not in continuous use. The aforementioned inspections should be integrated into the ship's operational maintenance routine.
Safety Management System, SMS.
Based upon the requirements of the ISM code, the following functional requirements may be applied to all ships. Refer to ISM code, Chapter 1.4. Every company should develop, implement and maintain a safety management system, SMS, which includes the following functional requirements.
A safety and environmental protection policy.
Instructions and procedures to ensure the safe operation of ships and protection of the environment in compliance with relevant international and flag state legislations.
Defined levels of authority and lines of communication between and amongst shore and shipboard personnel.
Procedures for reporting accidents and non-conformities in accordance to the provision of the code. Procedures for preparation for and response to emergency situations.
Procedures for internal audits and management reviews. Planned Maintenance System, PMS.
The Planned Maintenance System, PMS, as an integrated part of the Safety Management System, SMS, in compliance with the International Safety Management, ISM code.
The following rules for classification of ships and classification notes are applicable for the PMS system. Periodical survey requirements, DNV rules, Part 7, Chapter 2, January 1999. Alternative survey arrangements for machinery and automation systems. Ships and mobile offshore units classification. Note number 10.1, January 1999. Reference Classification Notes number 10.1, Chapter 4.4.
A PMS should be considered as a part of the management system and is considered to at least satisfy the minimum requirements laid down in the International Standard of Management Code, ISM, concerning class-related machinery items and the automation equipment covered by the rules. The basis for intervals and extent of maintenance are normally as recommended by the manufacturer, documented operator's experience, and condition monitoring where fitted. For all items or systems covered by the rules PMS, the maintenance category and job description for main overhaul of the respective items should at least cover or fulfill the rules for classification of ships, Point 7, Chapter 2. Table E1 Machinery Surveys. Requirements for class survey with respect to opening up, testing, etc. It's a condition that job description for main overhaul and class survey should be harmonized and given on the same job order.
Definition of main overhaul.
A representative interval inspection and, for example, measure tolerances, clearances, followed by replacement or overhaul, if a defect is detected. In cases where the overhaul consists of more sub-actions at different intervals, main overhaul is when the total cycle is completed.
When the manufacturer's recommendation for main overhaul intervals based on running hours or condition monitoring normally exceeds 5 years, the item can still be credited at the completion of the CMS cycle, provided that satisfactory maintenance history is documented. EO/EOC class notation. When the EO/EOC class is to be included in the PMS, test and intervals should not exceed the intervals as specified in the EO/EOS maintenance manual, and in no case exceed 12 months. The instructions for testing should cover the extent as specified in the EO/EOC maintenance manual and the rules for classification of ships, Part 7, Chapter 2, for annual and complete renewal survey. Responsibility for documentation on all maintenance work carried out on items, systems covered by the rules is to be signed by the chief engineer. With computer systems, the chief engineer is responsible for the updating of the system. A PMS is to include documentation of
inventory content, that is, items or systems included in the maintenance program, all class items to be covered,
maintenance time intervals, maintenance instructions, maintenance documentation and history, that is, records of maintenance jobs carried out and the result, routines for handling postponed jobs, that is, that the system is able to keep the control of new due date, reference documentation, that is, performance results and measurements taken at certain intervals for trend investigations, electrical equipment, that is, generators, EL motors, main and emergency switchboards, etc., including test maintenance procedure and time interval to be followed, instrumentation automation equipment, that is, if EO/EOC class is included, test maintenance procedures and time intervals to be followed,
condition monitoring, that is, if applicable, specification of machinery covered including
engine,
location and orientation of sensors and measurement points,
type and model of instrumentation, schedule of measuring, acceptance criteria, calibration interval of measuring device. It is a condition that baseline data are available. Routines for reporting and use of the maintenance history data to continuous improvement of the planned maintenance system. Examples of all these types of documentation are to be submitted in connection with the system approval, together with a description of the owner's manager's maintenance policy, organization flowchart, that is, identifying reporting procedures between vessel, owner's office and areas of responsibility, classification note number 10.1, chapter 4.5. When the owner's PMS has been approved and the system has been used on board for at least 6 months, the owner may request class society for an implementation survey in order to verify that the PMS is implemented in accordance with the approved documentation and that all components in CMS, EO/EOC, if applicable, are covered by the planned maintenance system. During the implementation survey, the surveyor shall verify that the following items are fulfilled. The ship is manned with a chief engineer having a valid authorization letter issued by the society in accordance with the requirements of the Rules for Classification of Ships, Part 7, Chapter 2. The personnel on board are familiar with and motivated towards using the planned maintenance system as an important tool for improving safety.
Every job description and extent of main overhaul must at least cover or fulfill the rules requirements for class survey with respect to opening up, testing, etc.
The system can produce printout summary of class-related items which have been subject to main overhaul since last annual survey. Acceptance criteria limitations are clearly defined if any maintenance intervals are based on condition monitoring, CM. It's clearly stated when maintenance intervals are based on operation hours. Routines for reporting and use of maintenance history data for continuous improvement of the PMS.